welcome and happy Easter. Happy Resurrection Day. He is risen. What a weird Easter. What a weird position that we're in. But let's continue making the most of it and just celebrating that today we have a huge reason to celebrate because Jesus is alive. And if you've been following along with our series, we followed the whole story from the time when Jesus was alive, the time when Jesus prayed in the garden because he was afraid and he prayed to give his fear to God. And we talked about how when Jesus's friend Peter, after Jesus was taken and arrested, Peter was afraid that this was going to happen to him too. He was afraid that because he was with Jesus and he was a friend of Jesus, that he was going to get arrested and he was going to get killed. And so he lied and he pretended that he never knew who Jesus was. And he let Jesus down. But we learned that Jesus ended up forgiving him after he rose from the dead, and how cool that was. And then last week we learned about the thief on the cross who was being punished, right? We know that Jesus was up there not because of anything he had done, but the two thieves that were on the cross beside him, they were being punished for their sin, for a bad thing that they had done. And so we know that they deserved to be punished. But when the one thief looked at Jesus and believed and placed his trust in him and asked Jesus for forgiveness, Jesus told him, "I will see you today in heaven," because of what he had done, because of the sacrifice Jesus made. The thief was able to be forgiven, and you and me and anyone who places their trust in Jesus is able to be forgiven too. So if you've been reading in our story today, you know that when Jesus came back to life, when Jesus rose from the dead, he appeared to his followers after his resurrection. In all four of the Gospels, all four of the Gospels, which are the books of the Bible that tell us about the story of Jesus, of his birth, death, and resurrection, that's Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. In all four of these books, the writers make a point to tell their reader that Jesus appeared to his followers and others after the resurrection. Mary Magdalene saw him in the garden where he was buried. The disciples saw him many, many times, sharing meals with him and talking with him. Many, many people saw that Jesus was alive between his death and the time he returned to heaven. What does that mean to us? Isn't that strange? It means we serve a Savior who is alive. He is not in the tomb. He's not buried. He has risen. And so when I say with you guys, he is risen, I say that because it's true, because it's a reason to celebrate that we serve a Jesus. We serve a Savior who is alive, who is with us all the time. He has risen. Jesus has conquered sin and death. Jesus has the power to take away our sins. And when we give our hearts to Jesus, he will give us a heart that's whiter than any socks in this room. He will give us a heart that's whiter than even your newest white socks. He will give us a new life. Throughout this series, we've talked about giving things to Jesus. When we read about Jesus praying in the garden, we saw that we can give our sadness and troubles to God. We can tell God when we are sad and he'll give us comfort. We also saw that we need to give God our fears so that he can give us courage, like Peter. After Jesus forgave him, he gave Peter courage to stand up for him. God can give us the strength to speak up for Jesus when people make fun of our faith. We can stand strong when others are doing the wrong thing and stand up to peer pressure. We can find the courage that Peter didn't have when he denied Jesus, and we can take a stand for our faith. We also learned that Jesus died for our sins. The blood he shed on the cross paid the price for every single one of our sins, the sins we have committed and the sins we will commit. He will give us a clean heart so that one day we can stand before him in heaven, blameless and holy. Becoming a Christian does not always mean that you will instantly become perfect. And it doesn't mean that life will be perfect. Things will still happen. You know right now, We are stuck at home. Our world is a mess because of what is happening right now with this sickness. We know that life doesn't become perfect because we put our trust in Jesus. But we also know that putting our trust in Jesus means he will carry us through even the craziest of storms, even the strongest of storms. Nothing is too big for him, and he will walk with us through the valleys of the shadow of death. And he will continue to make us holy if we give him our sadness and our fears and our sins. He will continue to make us holy, more into his image, make us more like him every day. And one day, he will take us to heaven to live with him forever. Jesus is alive. And the best thing of all is that he wants to be your friend. He wants to take away your sins and give you a new life. And that is why we celebrate Easter today. That's why we invite you every week to meet Jesus. Let Jesus come into your heart today. Let him begin his work in you, and let him give you a pure heart, a heart that is as white as snow, a heart that is whiter than any socks you could have in your drawer. Remember that Jesus is the only one who can give us new life, who can set us free from our sins. So we can give him our fears, we can give him our sadness, we can give him our sins, and remember that he is here with us always. Happy Easter. Let's pray. Dear Jesus, thank you so much that you don't just see me as a sinner. You don't just see me as someone unworthy of your love, but you see me as something beautiful that you created in your image. God, you see me as a creature that you love more than anything. And so, God, thank you that you love us so much. Thank you, Lord, for coming down to earth to be with us and to take the punishment for our sins on yourself, for dying and suffering on the cross. And God, most of all, thank you for coming back to life. Thank you that we serve a Savior who is risen, who is alive and with us today in our hearts. And Jesus, thank you that you speak to us, that you know our hearts. And God, help us to tune our ears to hear your voice. Help us to know when you are speaking to us. Help us to know, Jesus, that you are never going to leave us. You will never forsake us. We love you and we praise you today as we celebrate the fact that you are risen. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Happy Easter, everyone.